If you've been on the receiving end of the silent treatment, you know how emotionally painful that can be. It can cause crushing anxiety and fear that's often triggered from childhood experiences and a sense of powerlessness that you felt if one of your parents or caretakers was giving you the silent treatment. The silent treatment is a common tactic used by narcissists and other manipulators, especially the covert types. Now, keep in mind, the silent treatment isn't always a sign of a narcissist or other manipulator. It could also be a sign of someone who's emotionally immature, someone who is a bit cowardly, doesn't know how to deal with conflict in a healthy way. Either way, in any way, it's not a good sign. So in this video, I'm going to talk about what the silent treatment is and why narcissists and other manipulators and abusers do it. Then I'm going to give you some tips on what not to do and what to do instead. The silent treatment is a form of abuse, of neglect, of abandonment. It's when someone ignores you for hours, days, weeks even on end. It's a form of punishment and behavior modification. Essentially, it's a power game, and it's a passive-aggressive power game. When a narcissist or other manipulator gives you the silent treatment, they want to control your behavior. They want to feed off of the emotional reaction that you have when they ignore you. That gives them narcissistic supply. Now, keep in mind, that's very different from a healthy person who needs some time and space and says to you, "I need some time. I'm gonna get back to you tonight," or "let's talk tomorrow," or "let's set aside a time, you know, 2 days from now when we're gonna talk about this." Someone just needs to cool off, they need to process their emotions, they need to gather their thoughts, and then they're willing to come back and talk to you, but they let you know. They don't simply disappear. So why do narcissists and other manipulators do the silent treatment? This is a form of punishment, as I mentioned, and behavior control. So it means usually they didn't like something that you did. Now that could be you set a boundary. That could be you said no. That could be you were unavailable when they wanted you to be available. Maybe you wanted to go out with your friends one night instead of spending all of your time with that person and they got upset about that. Maybe you wanted to talk about something that happened between the two of you or about some of their unacceptable behavior, so they punished you and ignored you for trying to bring that up. Maybe you just had a close, intimate moment with them. Maybe you just said that you loved them. Or maybe you guys just saw each other a few days ago and then you contacted them to see if you could make plans for the next weekend and then they disappeared. What you'll notice is that abusers often use the silent treatment as a way of evading responsibility for their actions. So, what can you do if you find yourself in the middle of the silent treatment? First, I'm going to give you all the list of what not to do. These are probably going to be the very first reactions that you have and the things that you want to do. These are mistakes, okay? I've made these mistakes. You've probably made these mistakes. Don't make these mistakes again. Number one, don't beg for their love, their attention, their communication. Do not participate in the drama. That's what they want. They want to see you begging for them. Number two, don't apologize for something that you didn't do. So first you got to check in and ask yourself, did you do something wrong? Like, did you honestly do something that made that person want to take a step back? You know, did you hurt them? Did you say something offensive? Did you do something offensive? If you did, you have to own self-responsibility for that, okay? In that case, you do owe them an apology. But if you reflect on your behavior and you say, no, I didn't do anything wrong. I set a boundary. I said no. Those were healthy boundaries. You're allowed to set boundaries. So if that's the case and you didn't do anything wrong, you were just trying to have a conversation about something that happened, then you gotta remember, you don't owe them an apology. Don't go apologizing to them. Number three, don't cry to the abuser. Do not give them that. They would love to know how bad you're hurting. The crying is something you need to do in privacy. You're allowed to cry, okay? You're allowed to feel how you feel, but do that in privacy at home. Do it with your best friends. Do it with supportive family members. Do it with your therapist, but don't give that to the abuser. Number four, don't try to make the peace and smooth everything over. That's people-pleasing behavior. Okay, if you didn't do anything wrong, you don't need to clean up that mess. So you just wanna stop yourself if you notice that drive to make everything okay. That's probably coming from childhood where you were taught that you had to do that. You had to make the peace in order for your needs to get met as a child, like in order for you to be taken care of, in order to not be abandoned. And that's utterly terrifying to a child when their parent does this to them. Number five, don't try to reason with the abuser. Don't try to explain why and how it's hurtful what they're doing to you. They know. That's why they're doing it. Number six, don't coddle the abuser. Don't be, "Are you okay? What's wrong? What can I do for you? Look, I made you dinner. Hey, let's have sex." Don't coddle the abuser. These are also people-pleasing behaviors that you might find that you want to do to make everything okay. Number seven, do not stalk them. Don't stalk them online. Don't stalk them at their house, at their workplace, where you know they want to be hanging out. Usually what happens in a romantic relationship when you're getting the silent treatment, they're cheating on you with someone else. That is usually what happens. If it's a family member, a friend, they're also probably cheating in a different way. They're with somebody else. They're betraying you in some way. They're replacing you as their BFF. They're replacing you as their daughter, their sister, their whomever. And number eight, do not post passive-aggressive messages on social media to get their attention. You know, "Oh, silence is just so painful. Why can't people just talk?" You know, things like this, or memes that say the same thing. Don't do that. Just act like everything is normal. Don't put yourself out there like that, because you're gonna give the abuser exactly what they want. So what can you do instead? The very first thing is you want to recognize, like hit the pause button and recognize what's going on here. Label the behavior. This is called the silent treatment. I'm being given the silent treatment right now. This is also that good time to check in with yourself and see, did I do something wrong? Did I say or do something offensive? Did I hurt that person intentionally or unintentionally? If the answer is no, then you've checked off that box of self-responsibility, and you can recognize maybe instead you had set the boundary. You had done something that for the abuser was unacceptable. Therefore, now you're receiving the silent treatment. Next, you want to check in. What was the trigger for that person? And I'm not saying you're responsible for that, not at all. But it's good to notice. Was it that you set a boundary? You said no. You wanted to make time for your friends. You wanted to make time for self-care. You wanted to talk about something that happened that they didn't want to talk about. That's helpful to know. And then look at what is the trigger for you? Like, what is this triggering inside of you? The fact that this person is ignoring you, they're abandoning you, they're neglecting you. What is that triggering inside of you? It's probably something from childhood. Because if you never went through this in childhood, if someone did this as an adult, it's not going to hurt as much. It's not going to feel like excruciating pain, because your inner child is triggered and feeling that same terrifying pain of abandonment that a little child, defenseless in the world and powerless, felt. Really check in on that. You know, what is this bringing up? It's probably crushing anxiety. Like, it's probably so much anxiety, you can't even pay attention and watch a series or a movie or read a book or pay attention in class, fumbling around at work. Like, it's probably causing that kind of anxiety and also fear and terror that you're gonna lose this person or that something bad is gonna happen. So it's good to recognize what that's triggering in you, and labeling that is sometimes helpful to take the power away from those emotions. Then you want to evaluate your experience. So you've already reflected on what was the trigger for that person. So let's say you set a boundary. and that was the trigger. So now you want to evaluate, is this acceptable for me? Like, do I want to maintain a relationship, a friendship, a family relationship with somebody whom every time I set a boundary, I get the silent treatment? You know, is this a viable relationship for me? Is this meeting my standards of respect? Is this meeting my standards that protect my values? And you want to own your reality. So if you notice, this isn't acceptable. I set a boundary. I didn't do anything wrong. This person is punishing me because they think I did something wrong because I set a boundary. I'm not going to subscribe to that reality because that's not my reality. I'm going to own my reality in that it's okay that I set that boundary. And what's not okay is that I'm being punished for it. Next, you want to focus on your life. You want to focus on having fun, on spending time with friends, with family members, working on self-care, working on your hobbies, doing home projects that you've been putting off, making something beautiful in your home, getting something beautiful done to yourself, going out and playing sports or doing something that you've been neglecting in yourself because that person has been taking up a lot of your time. So start to focus on yourself. This is really important to keep yourself busy so that you're not reaching out to them. You are eventually going to want to face the feelings and really feel those feelings, but not yet. Because in this part, in this stage right now, when you're right in the middle of that silent treatment, if you allow yourself to feel those feelings too much, you might accidentally reach out to that person. And I say accidentally because it's like it's happening unconsciously. Like maybe consciously you're telling yourself, don't contact them, don't contact them, don't contact them. And before you know it, you've sent a text message. So this is a good time instead to focus on just living your life as if that person wasn't part of it. Let them take the step back to you or not. It might be that you're just getting ghosted. This might not be a silent treatment. They might have ghosted and they're gone. Or maybe they will come back. But the person who creates the distance is the person who has to close that distance. It's not on you to do that when the other person is creating that distance. Because if you do, you're just setting this pattern of them disappearing, giving you the silent treatment, and then you reaching out to them. So then they learn all they have to do is wait for you to reach out to them, and then they can act like everything is normal, like nothing happened. Don't chase a person who's giving you the silent treatment. Start reflecting. What would life be like without that person? Whether that's your romantic partner, a friend of yours, a family member, a coworker who's giving you the cold shoulder at work and ignoring you and going out to lunch without you and those kind of things. This can happen in any kind of relationship. Start asking yourself, what would life be like without that person? Because you're not in contact right now, right? It's been hours, days, weeks, however long this person is ignoring you. And start to question what that would be like, because this could be an easy transition to no contact. If you realize that this isn't a viable relationship for you, that person kind of did you a favor by giving you the silent treatment. Because now that's a lot easier for you to move into the no contact and to opt out of having contact with that person. If they don't want to be part of your life and on the same level of standards of respect that you have, let that person go. Why do you want to hold on to somebody who doesn't value you? And if they come back after days, weeks, however long, don't just go into that as if nothing had happened, because that's probably how the person is going to come back, acting like nothing happened, acting like everything is fine, just rug sweeping all of that. Don't rug sweep it, and also don't immediately engage with that person. So if it's a text message or a phone call, I wouldn't answer that right away. I would give it some time. I would continue doing the things that you're doing. Is that playing games? Yeah, kind of. But you gotta understand, you're in the middle of a game already. If you've been given the silent treatment, you are in a manipulative power game. So the normal rules of honest, open communication and relationships are not happening. If you show up like that, you're going to get taken advantage of. If you immediately answer that text, that phone call, them showing up at your door, and you just get right back into it like nothing happened, what are you teaching that person? You're teaching that person, they can keep doing this and you're gonna be fine. You're just gonna be waiting for them to call and text. You're just gonna drop everything else that you're doing in your life because nothing is as important as that person and talking to that person. That is not the message you wanna give them. So if you get that text, that call, the show up at the door, whatever, I would not answer that. I would wait a while, several hours, maybe the next day, and then get back to that person and ask them when would be a good time to talk. You know, because you're not just gonna get right back into things like nothing happened and sweep that under the rug because that behavior will keep repeating. But the bottom line is, guys, if you're seeing this behavior in a relationship, no matter what kind of relationship that is in your life, that's not a good sign. This pattern is going to keep repeating. That person is always going to be giving you the silent treatment anytime anything goes wrong because they don't know how to deal with it any different, or they want to punish you for setting boundaries and having a life and doing things that are healthy for you. So I really don't condone having relationships with people who do this. You might want to give them one chance if this is a new friend, someone that you're dating. But I could pretty much guarantee that if you saw this behavior once, there's nothing that you're gonna say to this adult person that's gonna suddenly make them see the wrong of their ways and stop doing what they're doing and start acting like a decent human being. It's just not gonna happen. So the silent treatment, again, coming back to the beginning, you know, even though this was about manipulators, abusers, narcissists, etc., coming back to the beginning, it could also be a person who's emotionally immature and unable to deal with conflict. The bottom line is it's not going to be a viable relationship if you want to have decent contact with people. Now, again, you got to look at what was normality in that relationship. This doesn't apply to friendships that you have, for example, people that don't live in your area that you don't see too often, but you guys are such good friends that maybe every few months you catch up and then you don't catch up again for a few months, but there's nothing wrong with that because that's just how your friendship is, right? That's very different than dating someone who you're having daily contact with or maybe almost daily contact with, and then they disappear for days or weeks. That's not normal. That's not a normal thing. So you also have to keep in mind the context and the patterns of that relationship. So I hope this video was helpful for you. If it was, give it a like or let me know in the comments below. If you want to share an experience that you had with the silent treatment, I would love it if you shared that below with other people who are going through this right now. I'm sending you a big hug.